My name is Evans Mutamba, and today we are looking at the book of James, chapter 3, verse 3 to 8. Here, James is discussing about the destructive nature of the tongue. Allow me to read. When we put bit into the mouth of horses to make them obey us, we can turn the whole animal, or take sheep, as an example. Although they are so large and driven by strong winds, they are steered by a very small rudder wherever the pilot wants to go. Likewise, the tongue is a small part of the body, but it makes great boast. Consider what a great forest it sets on fire by a small spark. The tongue also is a fire, a world of evil among the parts of the body. It corrupts the whole body, sets the whole course of one's life on fire, and it is itself set on fire by hell. Verse 7. All kinds of animals, birds, reptiles, and sea creatures are being tamed and have been tamed by mankind. But no human being can tame the tongue. It is restless evil, full of deadly poison. Now, in this portion of scripture that we have looked at, James is just looking at the entire part of the body called the tongue. And in this portion, he brings out three things that are critical. One is the tongue is powerful force. And two, the tongue is potentially destructive or dangerous. And three, the tongue hardly slips. Now, allow me to go back to the first point that James is discussing. He says the tongue is powerful force. And in this, he uses two things, illustrations. One, he uses the bit that's put in the mouth of a horse so that the whole body or the course of a horse can be controlled with a lot of ease. He also looks at the rudder of a ship. And again, he says, the ship is a big vessel, but it's not controlled by a big thing. It's a small thing called a rudder. And technically, what the writer is saying, the tongue is a small part of the body, but really the whole body and the whole life is controlled by this tongue. And that is very important for us to get to understand that the powerful tongue that is within our mouth, looking small, it has got the potential to make good of our lives or to make bad of it. And secondly, he looks at the destructive nature of the tongue, and I'm calling this, the tongue is potentially very dangerous or destructive. And he uses again two illustrations. He says the tongue is a fire. And in this, he's saying a small spark of fire lights up the whole forest. Meaning, this is a small thing, but the ability that it carries with it should never be underestimated. He says the tongue it sets the whole course of one's life on fire, meaning it has got the potential to totally destroy your life. And we have seen people's lives being destroyed because of the words they speak. And I'll be commenting on that at the tail end of this sharing. And there are three things that the writer would want us to know. Probably there are more, but I'll confine myself to three. Based on the book of Proverbs, he says, the tongue, with it we lie. And it's among the six things that God hates in the book of Proverbs, chapter 16, verse 17. One of them is the lying tongue. The Lord hates. And secondly, with the tongue, We use reckless words and they pierce in the lives of people. Really, we destroy the lives of people by the words that we speak. And again, the writer of Proverbs chapter 12, verse 19, he says, the words of the reckless pierce like a sword. They go through the heart, the mind, every being of a human being to bring that destructive nature. And with it, we tear down people's lives. And number three, without gossip, as he put it, a quarrel dies down. Meaning, technically, without gossip, a quarrel flares up, a quarrel expands and continues to wreak havoc in the lives of people. And so we need to be aware that the tongue has got the potential to destroy and the potential to bring havoc and harm in the lives of people. And finally, the tongue hardly slips. In Kenya, we hear of this thing being called slip of a tongue. Really, Jesus speaking about this aspect, he warned his disciples. And he says, for the mouth speaks what the heart is full of, in the book of Matthew chapter 12. And I've just taken part of verse 34. But you can read from 34 to 36. In other words, when one speaks, he is speaking from the abundance of heart. And so there's nothing like the tongue slipped. It is coming from within. And so we need to ask ourselves, what are we made of? What are we storing in our lives? Because that will pop up through our tongues. And that needs to help us to begin investigating our lives and interrogating ourselves whether we are on the right course. And finally, talking about the power of a tongue, Solomon in the book of Proverbs says this, the tongue has power of life and death, and those who love it will eat its fruit. King James Version really says, the power of life and death is on the tongue. In other words, we need to be careful with our tongues. And when James finishes by saying, it is hard to tame the tongue, we need to be aware that by human ability, strength, and our own effort, we can't tame our tongue. But we can always surrender our tongues to Jesus. He will help us. So God bless you as you reflect on this, on the destructive nature of the tongue.